Good morning everyone, I am Dr. Irandi from Plantation Villa. Today we are bringing you another breakfast item, which is rice pudding. So here we have two main ingredients. One is red rice, the other one is mung beans. Red rice is more compatible than white rice and easily digestible, so we highly recommend using red rice. Rice is like the sign of good health and prosperity in Ayurveda, and also it is compatible for all three dosha and easy to digest, gluten free and low and medium to low in glycemic index. We have mung beans here and this is soaked overnight. It is very important to soak the beans to activate them and make them easy to digestible. It also helps to reduce the cooking time, and it works in combination with the spices, it works well when it is soaked overnight. It is also easy to digest, but rich in protein, vitamins and folic acid, so high rich nutrition content in the mung beans. And we are going to combine these two together. There are common things in both main ingredients. They are both cooling and nourishing, providing nutrition to all the seven tissues. And both are sattvic, so it helps to maintain calmer, cooler and more balanced state in the mind. And we are combining some other ingredients to make the dish. We have coconut milk. We are using our coconuts from the garden. If you have coconut milk powder or in the can, you can use that. This is more compatible as the rich plant-based nutrition combination. If you don't have coconut milk, don't worry, you can use any kind of plant-based milk. Then we need some water. We are using some spices. We have some black pepper also from our garden, and we have some sea salt. We are using ginger and garlic. We need chopped ginger and garlic. They are both astringent and helping to maintain more balance in the whole ingredients, so they are the balancing agents. And then we have two ingredients, raisins and some roasted peanuts. These you can change as your preference. You can use anything to make it sweet, some plant-based honey, treacle, maple syrup, anything. And it's not necessary to add the sweetening agent if you don't like it. And we have some roasted peanuts. You can change this to cashews, almonds, pistachio or any other kind of nuts that you like to add. Okay, so let's start cooking. We are using red rice. Red rice is more digestible and more rich in nutrient content than the white rice. You can find red rice or any kind of white rice. You can look in Asian shops. It will be available, so it's better than refined type of rices. Again, we are using a clay pot. This is more recommended in Ayurveda. It's natural and also it adds a nice flavor to the cooking. So we are putting our rice into the pot, and then we have to add some water. Just put water like 2 centimeters above the rice level, and we let the rice cook a little bit before we add the mung dal. Then we have to add the spices. It's important in Ayurveda to add spices and let it cook together, so they will mix and work together with the balancing activity. And we are adding some salt. Not just to flavor, it is also very important component in Ayurveda diet. So then we have black pepper corns. Just a little bit of black pepper corns. All the two main ingredients in the dish is cooling, so we need some warm media to balance it. So black peppers will bring the pungent nature and make it more balanced in the end of the digestion. Then we have the ginger and garlic chopped. It's better to add it chopped, so it will be more active in the boiling media. So add a little bit of ginger and garlic. So now we have to let it cook a little bit, and then we can add our mung beans. So leave it for 5 minutes for the rice to cook. So now it's time to add the mung beans. Rice has been cooking for 5 minutes and it's halfway cooked. So it's time to add the mung beans. So add the whole portion. Soaked mung beans does not take that much time to cook, so they will both finish at the same time. a porridge is like a perfect consistency to a breakfast. It's a media that you can easily absorb the components of nourishment to the body. So it is very important and very much recommended in Ayurveda text to have a mushy, warm mixture of media that you can absorb easily. It help facilitate the digestion, and throughout the day you will feel more comfortable. You will not feel heavy or tired because it's easy to digest. Now it's been 2 minutes in the medium flame. Now it's time to add the coconut milk. This is rich media. It helps to make it more creamy texture, and also it helps to absorb the fat soluble vitamins in the beans, so it makes it more balanced. Amount of coconut milk depends on your preference, so you can add more or less as you wish. Now we let it cook for another 5 minutes and then it will be ready. You can serve it. The raisins and the nuts you can actually use to dress it. So you can use some raisins and whatever the sweetening agent and the nuts you prefer to add. So it's ready. I hope you enjoyed our cookery class. Stay in touch with us so you will be able to see more from Plantation Villa Kitchen. If you have any questions, you can comment or you can email us. Have a good day. Aibuwan.